perfect power and perfect speed. Isn't it amazing? Imagine for a moment that you're sitting inside a Formula One car. You're blasting down a straight at 355 kilometers per hour. Your heart is hammering. The vibrations are violent. The noise is deafening, and the world is smearing past your eyes in a blur. Time stops meaning what it usually means. In that chaos, your body does something completely natural. You blink. So what, right? It seems trivial. A blink lasts about a tenth of a second. But at this speed, in that one tenth of a second, the car travels roughly 20 meters. Not so trivial anymore. That's about the length of a tennis court. And for those 20 meters, you're effectively blind. Most drivers feel uneasy when they enter a sharp corner. But brain scans show that F1 drivers do something very different. Today, I'm going to show you how to copy that and adapt it to your own riding. Here's the data that should both scare you and fascinate you. Telemetry from top F1 drivers show something insane. They don't blink randomly. In corners under hard braking or during acceleration, they barely blink at all. Subconsciously, they time their blinks for the safest parts of the track, the straights. They are biologically managing their own blindness. Why am I telling you this? We don't drive F1 cars, and on the way to work, we definitely aren't doing 355 kilometers per hour. But the biology inside the helmet, that's exactly the same. The machine changes, the speeds change, the limits of the human brain don't. Today, we're not talking about suspension settings or the psychological benefits of riding. We're going to look at the neuroscience elite racer's use, and we'll figure out how you can use it to slow time down, reduce fear, and become a safer, smoother rider. This is the F1 principle. Let's start with your most critical and valuable sensor, your eyes. In motorcycle training, we're always told, look where you want to go. That's a golden rule, but scientifically, it has a simple reason behind it. First, we need to talk about two things. Visual scanning, and something researchers call the confidence ellipse. In Formula One, a high-load sport where milliseconds matter, visual information cannot be interrupted. If the stream of data breaks while the car is fighting for grip mid-corner, the brain loses its orientation. That's why they don't blink. On a motorcycle, the difference between a novice and an expert often comes down to the same data stream. Eye tracking research shows that new riders tend to focus their vision on a tiny narrow area just in front of the front tire. They're reactive. They spot the pothole or the gravel only when it's already too late to do anything meaningful. Expert riders scan a wider field. That's the confidence ellipse. They scan and process the horizon, the vanishing point, the road surface, and the mirrors, all in parallel. But here's the key paradox. And this is exactly where the F1 technique kicks in. When an expert rider detects a specific threat, maybe a car that looks like it might drift into their lane, or an oil patch, they switch modes instantly. They narrow that ellipse to lock onto the threat, just like an F1 driver refusing to blink in a corner. This is the lesson. Don't just stare at the road like a zombie. Manage your data stream. As you enter a corner, try to keep your eyes open. Don't blink at the apex. It sounds like a tiny detail, but if you want to survive, keeping that visual stream continuous tells your brain, we have control, we have the data. But seeing danger is only step one. Your brain has to process it and absorb it. And that brings us to the biggest bottleneck in human performance, the CPU problem. In psychology, there's a concept called cognitive load theory. Think of your brain like a computer with a limited amount of RAM, also known as working memory. At any moment, you can only process a certain amount of information. If your mental RAM is 100% filled with thinking about the motorcycle's mechanics, is my foot positioned right on the shifter? Where's the clutch friction zone? Am I in second or third? Then you have very little capacity left to register the child running into the street. You physically see the child and you know it's danger, but your brain is so busy shifting gears that it doesn't truly see it. That's what separates a world champion from a beginner. It's called spare capacity. You've seen drivers like Max Verstappen or Lewis Hamilton pulling 5G at the limit of traction, while calmly talking to their engineers on the radio about strategy and tire wear. How is that possible? It's absolutely possible. Because for those drivers, the driving part is automated. For us, the situation is simple and clear. Whether you're a new rider or even an experienced rider on a new motorcycle, your primary goal shouldn't be just riding, it should be automation. You need your brain to gain the ability to handle more than one task at once. Until your clutch control, brake pressure, and body position are managed by your subconscious, without you actively thinking, you're riding in a dangerous state. You're riding with a full CPU. Research even shows that visual distractions, like looking down at a GPS, can destroy your lane-keeping ability. Interestingly, auditory tasks like talking on an intercom can be less dangerous for experienced riders because your eyes stay up. Interesting, right? But if you have to look down to check a gear indicator, you've just blinded yourself for 20 meters, and you've lost your spare capacity. So what happens when you master your vision and automate your controls? You unlock the holy grail of riding, like eating the cherry on top of the cake. Psychologists call it flow. Athletes call it being in the zone. Flow happens when the challenge of the task matches your skill level perfectly. If the difficulty is at a level you can handle, everything clicks. It's a delicate balance. Picture a simple graph. If challenge is higher than your skill, you enter the anxiety zone. You know that feeling. Your arms stiffen, you grip the bars too hard and fight the suspension. You forget to breathe. As an old race rider once said, if you're scared, don't do it. Because when you're scared, you hesitate. And when you hesitate, you're in danger. If you feel fear in a corner, you've left flow. You're riding above your bandwidth. The solution is simple. Slow down until the challenge matches your skill again. Weirdly simple, right? On the other side, if your skill is high but the challenge is low, like a boring highway cruise, you enter the boredom zone. That's dangerous too because your mind drifts. You lose focus, and once again, you're in danger. To get back into flow, you need to artificially increase the challenge. I do this by turning it into a game. I look at the car ahead and bet with myself, will they change lanes? I try to shift so smoothly I can't even feel the transition. I try to predict what drivers will do just by watching their mirrors. It's a great practice. By keeping your brain engaged, you return to the zone where your reactions are sharpest. Before we finish, I want to give you a practical tool, something you can use even before you put your helmet on. It's a technique used by both Olympians and F1 drivers. I want you to try something right now. Close your eyes for 1 second. Imagine you're holding a bright yellow lemon. I know it sounds stupid. Just imagine it. It's cold and waxy in your hand. Now imagine taking a knife and slicing it in half. Juice runs onto your fingers. Now take one half, bring it to your lips, and take a big bite out of that sour, acidic lemon. Did you feel it? Did your mouth water a little? Mine did. There is no lemon. But your brain reacted physiologically as if there was. Your brain struggles to distinguish between vivid visualization and reality. Soviet Olympic teams used this for decades. They found that athletes who did mental training, basically sitting and visualizing their sport, improved almost as much as those doing physical training. You can apply this to riding. Before you even turn the key, sit on the bike for 2 minutes. Close your eyes. Visualize that difficult corner on your route. Don't just see it, feel it. Feel the brake pressure in your fingers. Feel the lean angle. Imagine the traffic merging. Build the mental program before the wheels even roll. Then when you reach that corner in real life, your brain thinks, oh, we already did this today. I know exactly what to do. Riding a motorcycle isn't just mechanics, it's biology. It's managing your blinking to avoid blind spots. It's automating your controls to create spare capacity. It's balancing fear and boredom to stay in flow. Ride smart, ride safe. Keep your compass pointed true.